So it's back to the drawing board to see how mobile phones or static sparks might cause explosions. Ignition is still proving to be difficult. Working with a smaller blast box should help them figure out the right fuel to air mix to achieve ignition.
You know, all of that spray presents a lot of surface area, and I think it's probably sinking down and collecting right at the ground. My guess is that one of our mistakes with the big chamber was that we had the ignition source too far above the ground. So let's just see whether this works.
To generate a more consistent trigger for the ignition, Jamie has constructed a device called a Jacob's ladder. It generates a continuous high-voltage spark. This is no toy. It's potentially lethal.
Now, be careful on this metal. You know, we've got some pretty heavy-duty currents here, so. Okay.
All right, shall we lose the spark and get some gasoline going and blow some stuff up in miniature?
Adam has improved his Leyden jar. The heavy-duty version will provide a potent spark. And finally, they're getting an ideal blend of fuel and air.
Well, I lost a lot of hair on my arm. How about that? It definitely works. Okay, now I'm afraid.
Adding more liquid petrol won't guarantee a bigger blast. The critical mix needs more air.
That's probably it. That's probably all that it takes. Do you think there's anything left of a fume in there?
Go, go, go.
Okay, here I go.
Let's talk more sparks.
Stop your grinning and grab your linen. Here we go. Heinemann was right.
We now know exactly what kind of concentration of fuel that we have for ignition. We know that we can create a spark from static electricity off of fabric, and we know that it is something that we have to be very careful with.
I'm fine. Am I missing an eyebrow? I am missing an eyebrow, aren't I?
You lost a lot of air up there, too.
You're kidding me.
No. You're all right. It's not gonna, it won't look weird after a day or two. I think it took him about 5 seconds to worry about whether he's going to look funny for his date.
I have a date tomorrow.
Is it survival more important or sex?
All in the name of science.
Okay, that was probably one of the stupidest things I've ever done.
No problem now with the static spark. The mix is right, and ignition comes easily. But what about the mobile phone? Will it prove to be the cause of petrol pump fires?
Nada. Niente. Second call. No explosion.
So, Bob, have you heard of this myth regarding exploding a gas station by using a cell phone?
Not only did I hear of it, I'm quoted in the myth. That says, Mr. Rinkus says, don't use cell phones. They can cause fire at the pump. That email's gone around, and people take that literally because they are believing everything they see in emails, unfortunately.
After researching hundreds of petrol station fires, Bob Rinkus of the Petroleum Equipment Institute says mobile phones are in the clear.
Pure and simple, we don't have any accidents involving a cell phone at a service station. It just doesn't happen.
But a dramatic fire department demonstration clearly shows what can happen when static is involved. People who re-enter the car during refueling face the biggest risk.
They're typically younger people, because older people will go like this to get out of their car. And when they do that, they discharge. So they just simply pop out of the car, not touch anything, not shut the door, not ground themselves, not touch this. They'll take two steps, they're wearing neoprene shoes, so they're not discharging, they're not dissipating on the concrete. They touch a piece of metal here, the vapors are coming out of the tank, the air is coming in from outside, so that's two parts of the fire triangle, and the third part is a source of ignition, which is the spark. The problem comes is when they overreact, they go, oh my goodness, and they leave a stream of gasoline. They already have a fire, it gets underneath the car, or they could get it on themselves.